I love cooking with pears, and I particularly love greedy, puddingy pear cakes. I'm hoping that this pear and almond pudding cake will be the perfect partner to my Gloucestershire perry and will help me win over the Devon cider drinkers at the cider pressing party in a couple of days. I'm just going to start these pears in a little bit of sizzling butter. First, to help tenderise them, put a little bit of colour on them for flavour, but also, by adding some sugar, I'm going to make a lovely little gooey sauce that's going to make a crunchy topping on top of my cake. I'm just using the weight of the pears to stir the sauce and dissolve that sugar into those buttery pear juices. And once the pears are tender, set them aside. And now for the cakey bit, which is really easy. Start with 300 grams of butter and whisk until fluffy. For a really light finish, I like to whisk the butter until it's distinctly paler. Add 250 grams of caster sugar. Crack open 4 eggs and whisk in a little at a time. Right, now for the dry ingredients. Some self-raising wholemeal flour. 150 grams is what I need. Followed by an equal amount of ground almonds. Fold it all together, and then for a little winter warmth, cinnamon. Definitely optional and definitely to be used with caution, but I do like a little pinch on my pears. And that's pretty much it. In fact, this recipe is a cakewalk. This is one of those cakes that's just so finger-licking, sticky and exciting that I just can't wait to get it into the oven, get it out of the oven and devour it. Perfect. The sticky sauce goes over the top and the slices of tender fruit sink into the gooey almondy mix during the 40 minutes it takes to cook. Ooh, this is looking good. So when they don't come out on the top of your cake, it doesn't mean your pud has gone pear-shaped. It's got this lovely toffee-ish crust. And ooh, look at that, look at that. That is a piece of gooey, yummy, caramelised pear. And with a warm, sticky cake like this, don't wait for it to cool down. Just tuck in. I have to say, I've rarely felt greedier.